Hey there, this is Jamie the D.
And I'm Major JF.
And we're here with Wipeout XL. Third best in the series. We're going to be racing with the AG Systems craft. More on that in a bit. Although, look at that shield. Oh, God.
Yeah. Shield actually matters here.
Because this is the first game where you can explode.
Fun times. Fun times.
Because this is Talon's Reach, I'm not going to be showing that off. Also, what I'm showing off here is... yeah, you have two tracks in each class at the moment. I'll be talking about that more in other videos, but it's a bit of a weird unlock system.
Yeah.
Also...
That's putting it mildly.
Also, Red Bull improves your reaction time, apparently. We're going to be seeing that a lot, because Red Bull sponsored this game. They also helped the nightclub tour that made this game popular.
It could be worse.
So, as you can see, the time trial ghost when you start the game is piss poor.
Yeah.
We're not going to lap it this time around, but we will.
Yeah, that's doable.
Also, go on.
It's also weird with the ghost, how it always takes your best time. That's weird because it's always somewhere in the race that you've gotten that best time. And so you have this extremely hyper fast ghost that you can't catch up to on your first lap.
Well, in this game, they keep the time trial and the arcade time separate.
Oh.
Which is a nice touch. And as to Talon's Junction itself, it's not really much. This is the only difficult part of the track. And for anything with halfway decent handling, there is no difficult part of the track. Also, see that? That's the pit stop.
Is that to get energy back?
Yep, that is to get shield energy back. Shield energy, by the way, is... it replaces air brakes as the most important mechanic. Because every time you crash into a wall, properly crash into, not grind, and every time you get hit, you will lose shield energy. Once you've lost all your shield energy, well, we'll hear what happens this video, and I'll show you what happens later.
I can hardly wait.
Oh yeah, this is a great track. So last time I screwed up boost start, this is how you do it properly. It's easy in Excel. Get it to slightly less than 1.5 bars from the end. Also, on your first lap, don't go for both those boost pads. It's a bad idea.
Because there's other cars in the way, or...?
Yeah, and they'll take your speed from you, as it were. But, watch this. And then...
okay!
Yeah, that is how quickly you can potentially die in XL.
Yeah. Well, you can see my face.
I'll bet. It's the face I had when I first saw that. So, yeah, you may have noticed we ground against the walls a little bit on this lap, but still got a perfect. This is because grinding against the walls is perfectly acceptable. It doesn't count as a collision. And in later games in the series, there's actually a sort of physics bug where it will, in certain situations, speed you up.
Oh.
Yeah. But unfortunately, this changes from, I think, Fusion onwards. Either way, two laps. For Vector class, the slowest class in the game, so it's nice and quick. We're already done.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah, we got a shiny gold medal. Well, it's meant to be gold, but God knows, because it's ultra shiny.
Yeah. It looks more like brass.
Yeah, yeah. But then you got a brown shiny thing for bronze. So, next time, we'll have Sagamartha, otherwise known to me as Slowdown City.
Bye.
Take care.